6 o'clock. Shipping terminal's on a modified schedule today, which means they opened at 7. They'll be closing for lunch. We brought in a load of dunnage to the shipping terminal from our terminal, and then we picked up a load of air conditioners. We just finished that movement, and now we're making our way back to the shipping terminal to pick up our third movement. You can see the schedule there. 7 to 11:15, and then 1 to 3:45. So our next movement is a load of flooring product. I think it's bamboo flooring. To a flooring distributor about a mile away, so it's a nice easy run. According to the paperwork, the container is located in Bravo 23, stall 16. My finger is still kind of sensitive, so I can't put a glove on it, but I use a rag to protect my hand. Thank you. Lights, you good? But look at all these handles. Not one of them is locked. See, because I put this seal in here, you can't get the handle closed now. It's slightly bent. Missing mud flaps. That's all right. I'm not a real stickler for mud flaps. It is a DOT violation, but to me it doesn't mess with the safe operating. But you're only going 2 miles away. Pretty good. Check the brakes. So the safety officer came out this morning and added some more paperwork. He wanted us to record our pre-trips as to what we found on the vehicles, primarily the company vehicles, but I'm adding the shipping terminal vehicle, I mean chassis and containers too, so they just have a record of what we're going through every day. Sink down every time a heavy truck would go over it. So I took some pictures of it and I sent it to the city and county and told them, hey, you know, you got the sinkhole right in front of this drain here. It's getting worse and worse. So they came out and they threw a bunch of asphalt on top of it. It still sinks down. pounds, which is pretty heavy for a 20-foot container, we could get pulled in.
Something about it.
double stack flooring inside. Those are the only containers I've ever seen flip forward. In other words, what happens is truck disconnects, it's on the dock, they're offloading the container, and when the forklift goes in to pick up those last pallets of double stack tile, or in this case bamboo flooring, the container falls forward on the landing gear, and the back end of the wheels go up in the air. I've seen that happen twice with this type of load. So it's something you need to be aware of if you're working on a flooring company. I've never seen it happen with a 40-foot container. I've only seen it happen with 20-foot containers, and I've seen it happen three times. Twice with flooring tile. Actually, one was bamboo flooring, one was flooring tile. It wasn't at this location, that was a different location. And then once in our yard, we had bottled water that was double stacked. And they went to... No, it wasn't even palletized, it was floor stacked. And they went in with a forklift to load the floor stack water onto the pallet on the forklift, and the whole thing went forward. Luckily nobody got hurt, because that could have killed somebody easily. If you're in that container and the forklift is in there with you and you fall forward. And then the only way to get it set back up is to bring in a heavy lift forklift. Not forklift, but a tow truck. And they put a winch on it, stabilize it. And you'll see the jack stands at loading docks put underneath the kingpin. That's what they're there for, to keep that from happening. So we're going to make a left back onto Sand Island Access Road. As soon as we do, we'll make a right turn into the road that gives us access to the back of this distribution warehouse where the loading dock is, which is more than likely locked up, so we'll have to go inside and get somebody to open it up. didn't take very long at all. 9:20.
Half an hour.
So now we'll take this empty 20-foot container back to where we got it from, the shipping terminal. Just a couple miles away. First, we gotta ease on out onto the Sand Island access road. Be busy at times, most of the time. Movement of the day, empty 20-foot container, headed back to the shipping terminal. After this, we'll have to call dispatch to find out what else to do, because she only gave me three movements to get the day going. Drivers went home early today, but it was a pretty good day for me. Of course, they keep me late because I'm off tomorrow, but we came in at 6. We'll be out of here by 3:15. We did 9 movements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Actually, 8 container movements, 1 chassis movement. We drove 85 miles. Pretty normal day, actually. This would be considered the norm. But we're gonna head on home. I got tuna fish on the back. I want to make a tuna dip salad, something I can eat on a salad, but eat with crackers too. That's what I'm craving. Plus whatever leftovers there are. I think I've eliminated most of the leftovers. So we're off tomorrow. We're gonna concentrate on losing a little weight. Try to eat sensibly and do a little more exercise and try to do a little more besides watch TV. But yeah, that's about it for today though. Thanks for watching today. Aloha.